to Better Faith e-learning platform. My name is Basil Ogemada and I'll be taking you physics for the SS3 classes, where our major focus is going to be for the white pass questions on linear expansivity. Now, many of us are in the SS3 classes. Remember vividly that we actually carried out some problems on linear expansivity while we're SS2. We did linear expansivity. Many of you are very conversant with area expansivity and that of the world, the cubic expansivity. But now, if you look at the way this question was being forwarded to us by the YEQ, it points out that there is a little difference in the questions we are going to be having here. So right now, we are going to be reading these questions and actually knowing the format at which we are supposed to answer them, depending on how the question are given to us. Now, we have A. It says, what is meant by the statement? The linear expansivity of a solid is 1.0 times 10 raised to the power minus 5 per Kelvin. Now, B says, Roman figure 1, describe an experiment to determine the linear expansivity of a steel rod. The Roman figure 2 says, steel bars, each length 3 meters at 29 degrees Celsius, are to be used for constructing a rail line. And we are told that if the linear expansivity of the steel is 1.0 times 10 raised to the power minus 5 per Kelvin, calculate the safety gap that must be left between the successive if the final temperature increases to 41 degrees Celsius. Then C is telling us, state two advantages and two disadvantages of thermal expansion of solid. Now, if you look at the question, many of us can see about clearly that most of the definitions you are used to might be what is linear expansivity. Now, please, you have to take note that there's a big difference between what is linear expansivity and what is meant by the statement that the linear expansivity of a solid is 1.0 times 10 raised to the minus 5. Although, from the ordinary meaning, taking away English language expression from it, many of us will be able to say, okay, linear expansivity can be defined as the increase in length per unit length and per degree rise in temperature. But we are not actually giving the statement in relation to the way the question is given to us, meaning that we have differences or we have a way and mode that we have to place them. Now, we have been told that we are giving a specific linear expansivity to be 1.0 times 10 raised to the power minus 1 minus 5. Now, looking at this kind of expression, try to put our definition in form of this expression, which is in the form of an English construction, you can say that the increase in length per, that is the increase in length of a steel of a solid per unit length per degree rise in temperature of that solid is 1.0 times 10 raised to the minus 5 per Kelvin. Now I repeat that the increase in length per unit length of a solid per degree rise in temperature of that particular solid is 1.0 times 10 raised to the power minus 5 per Kelvin. Now, looking at that statement, you now discover that in the way at which the definition was placed, there's a slight difference between what is linear expansivity and what is meant by the statement that the linear expansivity of a solid is 1.0 times 10 raised to the power minus 5 per Kelvin. So, many of us should be very, very conversant or used to these things. Now, many of us that have done specific capacity before, they can just ask you a question like, what is meant by the statement? Many of them are used to the fact that we are actually studying defined linear expansivity, defined area expansivity, or defined cubic expansivity. But they are not, in a way, trying to modify these questions to actually know how we are actually to put this kind of definition to suit the question given to us. So, we are having a great difference. Now, many of us know that most physics topics have a lot of experiments to actually prove them. Now, the B aspect tells us to say, describe the experiment to determine the linear expansivity of a steel rod. Now, before we started our linear expansivity, remember clearly that before we went into linear expansion, there was a little laboratory experiment that was carried out talking about the ball and the ring experiment and the bar and the gauge experiment. Now, all those are mere laboratory experiments which many of us are used to. And many of us have actually discovered them in the lab while we explain it. But when it comes to using a steel rod, now take note, Steel is different from most metals. And the way and format we are going to put it is actually going to be different from the normal bar, that is the bar and the gate experiment and the ball and the ring experiment. Now, if you look at what we have on the board, we are having a diagram which many of us are used to. Now, for those of us that understand the principle of heat transfer, while you were in SS1, if you look at this structure, we are having a wood base. And you know very much better, when it comes to linear expansivity, there is a low conduction of heat when wood is actually applied. Now, first of all, we have a wood base. We have a micrometer screw gauge at which many of us knows the uses of the micrometer screw gauge. Now here, we have the thermometer. And many of us knows what the thermometer is used for measuring decrease and increase in what? In temperature. Then we have a column where steam can go out. Many of us know what steam is all about. Now we have the steam coming in and we have the steam coming out. Now we have a column here. Of which those of us that have done specific heat capacity, you actually know that this diagram or this picture you are seeing here is actually trying to prevent heat from escaping from this direction. Meaning that we have an outlet where the steam can escape, and we have an outlet where the steam can go in. Now we have a jacket. Now the very first thing in carrying out this experiment is this. Now the length. Now this is the steel rod. At first, if you remember very clearly, the length of the steel rod is actually measured by a meter rule. That's the first step. You have to know the length of the steel rod. Now, before the steel rod is being positioned inside this particular point. Now, after that, the thermometer is used to measure the initial temperature at which this steel rod is encompassed in this environment. Now, immediately after that, the micrometer screw gauge is adjusted to actually check the nature of this steel rod. Adjusted. The later is being reduced back in a way to create some kind of space paraventure there's any form of expansion. Now, we have actually stated the parameters before this experiment. Now, what is going to happen is this. Steam, hot steam, is actually introduced into this outlet. Now, take note. While we are doing linear expansivity, we said something about re-expansion and apparent expansion. Although there are when some solids encounter a high amount of temperature, there will be an expansion that will not be visible to the eyes, of which many of us know. Now, if you look at most expansion or most expansivity, you discover that there's always a kind of 0.000. Maybe that's a 0.003 per Kelvin, meaning that the eyes may not actually know the length. Now, for those of us that have experienced, like I've actually told many of us that most of the time when you are in your houses, at the very high temperature, you begin to hear the noise from your ceiling or from your roofing sheet. Now, what actually is going on? Because of the heat that is actually falling on those steel, you begin to hear as if stones or little sand are falling on top of those roofs. Now, what actually is going on is a kind of a little expansion. Talking about contraction that actually was going on. Because of a kind of restricted spaces, you begin to hear some noises. And many of us can remember why there was a question that was being asked here, hot water is being placed on the glass cup. And after some time, you begin to hear noises. Where we said that all those actually happen as a result of what? Of the uneven expansion of the glass in relation to that of what? Of the water. Now, during this process, the steam is passed into it and left for some time. Now, the reason for this thermometer is to measure the final temperature at which this steam is subjected to. Now, remember, an initial temperature was made while this steam was not subjected to steam. Now, the steam has now been applied into it, and it has now, the temperature at this point of this steam has now increased. So the thermometer has actually taken the temperature of the steam. Now, at this point, heat is allowed to go out. And many of us can remember in SS1, you know what this principle means, talking about convection, where there's a kind of a circular movement of the upward and downward movement of heat as a result of convection. Now, it is now made. Now, take note, this steam has now been subjected to high temperature. The thermometer has now been used to measure. meaning that we are going to be having final temperature. Now, the initial length, the final length. Now, take note, this thermometer measured an initial temperature and a what? A final temperature. Now, for us to get the linear expansivity of this, many of us know that the definition of linear expansivity, we have an increase in length. That is the change in length, or you can use as change in length, all over what? That is the initial length multiplied by the what? The change in the temperature. Talking about the initial, or in the sense that you can use this symbol for the change in length all over initial length brackets the change in what? In temperature. Now, after performing this experiment, all these parameters are supposed to be noted and stated according to what you have here. Now, take note, this initial length was actually the length while this thing has not yet been subjected to steam. Now, the final length, the steam has passed through it and it's not being remeasured. You will now discover that there will be a slight increase. Now, take note, many of us know this of the micrometer screw gauge. Then, after that, from here, we cannot deduce the fact to prove that the linear expansivity of this steel rod is what? Is the increase in length per degree length per degree what? Rise in what? In temperature. Meaning that there was a temperature difference at this very point. So, during this process, we've finally been able to explain the function of these parameters and this diagram in this particular point. Now, from there, we have been able to prove through this experiment the linear expansivity of a steel rod. Now, take note please, for the sake of examination and summary, it's actually advisable for us to make sure that our diagrams are clearly stated and neat, then the parameters should be stated, and try your best to be brief. Now that white papers are, now the spaces are being limited for writers. So from here, we've been able to prove the experiment. Now, we go to Roman figure 2, which you know that there are most questions that, most of these questions, in all of them, you should be able to get a calculation or a calculated aspect of it. Now, steel bars, each length 3 meters at 29 degrees Celsius, are to be used for constructing a rail line. If the linear expansivity of the steel is 1.0 times 6 minus 5 per Kelvin, calculate the safety gap. Now, you know, one of the major problems that most of us encounter is the ability to understand the English expressions of this question. Now, somebody will ask us a question, maybe somebody that might not be enlightened on this will be asking, when we are saying safety gap, what do you mean by safety gap? Now, they could have replaced this one with the increase length. They could have replaced this one with all that we're talking about the final length. But using this same figure, take note, they have to try to know if we can actually understand that what they're asking us to find is the whole of this. We're looking for the same figure. If we get the final length and we get the initial length, definitely, if we should subtract both of them together, we are getting the same figure. So using this safety gap here is just trying, because they know that many of us are used to calculate the final length, calculate the increased length, but they are not using a safety gap, trying to modify the question. So quickly, many of us that know how to do that, you will just come and you know your general formula, that is you have your linear expansivity is equals to the change in length all over the initial length, multiply by the what? The change in temperature. This is what we are looking for. Take note of that. We do not need to be fixing the formula by using this format. No. What we just need to do, now your linear expansivity given to you is 1.0 times 10 raised to minus 5 is equals to, now since this is what we are looking for, that should be your subject of the formula, and our initial length is 3, bracket. You know how we are giving final temperature as 41 minus 29. Now, for the safety or for the purpose of write so that we will not consume more spaces, just write change in length is equals to 1.0 times 10 raised to minus 5 times 3 times bracket 41 minus 29. And at the end of the day, for those of you that have a calculator, you'll be able to understand that multiplying all of them together, looking at this value minus raised to the power minus 5 or 10 raised to the power minus 5, you should know that the value you are going to be getting, the increase in length, is going to be less than 1. So we are going to be having 3.6 times 10 raised to the power minus 3, if you press the calculator very well, which can be equals to 0.0036 meters. So from here, you can now see the short format. So using this principle, you don't need to consume a lot of spaces. One, you have saved your paper, and you don't put the format, put your calculator, and you get your value. So this is the increase in length. If you are asked to find the final length, that is why you cannot decide to say, okay, I want to add 3 plus this, which will now be having 3.0036 meters. Now, looking at the other question, it says state 2 advantages and 2 disadvantages of the thermal expansion of solid. Now, many of us know, and I guess many of us can still remember what we did, they are used for measuring, they are used for manufacturing bimetal strip. Many of us know what bimetal strip is all about. Talking about our pressing iron, you know the importance of the bimetal strip. Why? Here I explain that it gets to a time where after using your pressing iron, you hear a kind of noise. Don't make that noise. Come, and immediately, the something goes off. Not that you've disconnected it from the socket, but the bimetal strip has gotten to that point where the expansion, it has gotten to the temperature where it has to what? It has to disconnect themselves. For those of us that think what they call the bimetallic thermometer. Then so it helped in the manufacture of what? Bimetallic strip, and it helped in the removing of rivets from circular parts. Removing of what? Of rivets. Rivet. ROI. Many of us know that ROI what? VETS. Rivets. So I can remember there was a question that was being asked. They said, how will you be able to remove a white a past question? How will you be able to remove a ring? They know very much better. If they ask that question directly, you will know. How will you be able to remove a ring from a container that is filled with oil or a solidified granite oil, for example? Now, what you don't need to do, there is no now. During that initial temperature, everything is stiff. What you don't need to do, take it close to the temperature or close to the heat source. Then during that process, there is expansion. You will be able to remove it clearly. What they want to do is they want to actually know if you have that ability to apply what you know here, because most of the times you will not be given the opportunity to be taught directly. Then finally, we have what are the disadvantages. Anything that has an advantage must definitely have what? A disadvantage. Linear expansion have a very great effect for rail lines. Expansion of bridges. During that process, that's why I discovered that most of the time when engineers do construction, for the purpose of future, there is always gaps they create. So that during the process of expansion, they will not be struggling with others, just like that of the bottle. Here you apply hot water, and because of this one is trying to expand, the other one is not moving, then during that process there is going to be a crack. So during that process, there are spaces given. So it normally affects bridges, then secondly, for rail lines. So during that process, when trains are working on that rail line, there are a lot of problems that they will encounter, of which many of us know this. Now listen carefully, this is the end of this question. Now, whenever you see this kind of question, try your best to make sure that this is the big shot in the question, the experiment and your calculation. But that does not mean you will not take this one serious, though. But be very careful, because they know that if they ask you directly, you just give it straight away. So, on this note, we'll have to call an end to this. And I will advise everyone of us to please go to your past questions and see the way at which these questions are brought forward. And at the end of the day, you'll be able to know how to tackle such questions. I wish every one of us good luck as we wait for the pandemic to be over. God bless you.